गुड आफ्टरनून, आई एम रुशाली धनोका, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट एट ASMS IOIT पुणे. सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल लर्न अबाउट द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज बायस थ्योरम. सो लेट्स सी हाउ एग्जैक्टली बायस थ्योरम विल वर्क. सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द बायस थ्योरम, द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज कंडीशनल प्रोबेबिलिटी. आई थिंक यू ऑल आर फैमिलियर विद द कंसेप्ट ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी. Probability means possibility. How many times a particular number and particular things will be occur? This is the concept of probability. So the probability of event occurring, given that another event has already occurred, it's called as conditional probability. See here, there is the particular outer set, that is universal set, is shown as not possible to happen as B already happened. Means in this particular universal set, there are two events, A and B. So here, A event is already occurred at the time of B. So this is called as conditional probability. If A event is occurred, then B event is occur, right? And this is the formula of conditional probability. That is, probability of A given that B equal to probability of A intersection B upon probability of B. This is a conditional probability formula. So when you calculate the probability of A given that B, means A event is already occurred, and what is the chances of B event? Okay, so probability of A given that B is equal to, they calculate the probability of A and B upon probability of B. So this is the conditional probability. So about Bayes theorem. So Bayes theorem is also known as Bayes rule, Bayes law, or we can say Bayesian reasoning. So Bayes theorem generally determines the probability of event or with uncertain knowledge. Bayes theorem was named after the British mathematician Thomas Bayes. So Bayes theorem is calculate the value of probability of B given that A with the knowledge of probability of A given that B. Means A event is already occurred. So how many chances of B event is there? And if B event is already occurred, then how many chances of A event is there? So the calculation of this thing is called as Bayes theorem. So Bayes theorem allows updating the probability prediction of an event by observing the new information of the real world. So this is a Bayes theorem formula. As we have already discussed, Bayes theorem gives the conditional probability of an event A and given another event B has occurred. So I will explain this Bayes theorem with example. So here is just a formula, that is probability of A given that B equal to probability of B given that A, probability of A upon probability of B. So this is a Bayes theorem formula. So I will explain with example. Let's see. Okay, now see here, this is the example of Bayes theorem. So from the deck of the card, I think you all are familiar with the cards. So from the deck of the cards, you need to find out the probability of card being picked, and the pick card is a king card, okay. And this king card is also a face card. So this can be represented as probability of king, and this king card is a face card. So you need to find out the probability of this thing. Okay. So there are total 52 cards in deck. So n equal to 52. There are total 52 cards. So from that 52 cards, 12 cards are the face cards. There are total 12 cards for king, queen, jack with club. Right? King, queen and jack with club, diamond, heart and spade. So there are total face card. See in this diagram, king having 4 cards, queen having 4 cards and jack having 4 cards. Means how many face cards are there? There are total 12 face cards. Okay, this is called as face cards. So there is a set of face cards with 12 members, and there is a subset of king cards with 4 members, right? King card having the 4 subsets. So this is a scenario. So you need to identify that when you pick a king card, how many chances or how many probability, what is the probability of you pick a king card, and this king card is a face card. So see here, we will put up this all things into the Bayes theorem formula, that is probability of king divided by face given that face equal to probability of face given that king, probability of king upon probability of face. Here A is king, B is face. So in this way, these all values are put up into the formula. Now see here. So first you need to identify according the formula probability of king. Okay. So 4 members are king cards out of the 52 cards. Okay, there are total 52 cards in the deck, right? So this is 52, and from that 52 cards, 4 cards are the king cards. See, diamond, spade, club. Okay, so these 4 cards are called as king cards. So 4 by 52 equal to 1 by 13. Next thing is, you need to identify a probability of face. So from that 52 cards, 12 cards are called as face card, right? 4 for king, 4 for queen, and 4 for jack. Means how many? 12. 12 cards are called as face card. So 12 by 52 equal to 3 by 13. So after probability of king and probability of face, the next, you need to identify probability of being face given king. See here, probability of face given that king. So king card is always a face card, right? So the probability is equal to 1. So here we have a prior knowledge that if the card is king card, so it is a face card only, 100% sure, so it is always 1. Okay, so you need to put all these values into this formula. So after putting all those values into the Bayes theorem, see here, 1 into 1 by 13 upon 3 by 13, okay, and final answer is 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 is a probability that you have to pick a king card from that 52 card, and king card is a face card. So in this way, Bayes theorem is used. So in Bayes theorem, we use this formula. Okay, so every formula having a proper naming convention. See here, the first one is probability of A given that B. This concept is called as posterior. Posterior means probability of A. A, this condition is already occurred as compared to B. Next, probability of B given that A. This concept is called as likelihood. Probability of A is called as prior, and probability of B is called as evidence. So these are the just naming convention used in Bayes theorem. So these are the some applications of Bayes theorem. Bayes theorem generally used to calculate the next step of the robot when the already executed step is given. If the particular thing is already executed or already happened, then you need to identify the chances of probability of next thing. So Bayes theorem is helpful in weather forecasting and also solving some logical puzzles and games. So this is all about Bayes theorem. Thank you.